Good.
Alright, so we're gonna put this, this bearing on the pinion is a pain in the balls to get on there. You don't want to use a socket, you don't want to damage the bearing. So, I'm gonna use a 10 mil. Deep socket over it, and another bearing that's just going to sit right on the end here. There's a gap, and I'm hoping I don't have to push the pinion bearing all the way down, but I think it's going to want me to push it a little bit further, but just based on this gap here. That here is pretty big. Let's put these two together. I don't have that big of a gap. I want to try to stick the pinion out as far as you can. Make good contact with your ring gear. Check that. Okay, it worked out really good. So, you don't want to have the ring gear, that's why you want to keep this a little bit off. You don't want to have it sitting on your hub there and going around like that. You want it to be nice and neat, a little gap in there. Pretty close to it. Just enough off. So, you put your bearings in your hubs. And then you're gonna stick this bad boy together. This is where that gap comes into play. Might be off just a little bit. It should just slide together nice and easy. Let's see if it's the bearing on the end or the bearings on the pin. I think this is top. And this is sit. This is sitting down a little further. In order to do that, we're going to have to push the pinion. Just bearing down a little further, which I don't want to do, because it's already. Already down, pretty close to the. Already hitting a little bit. And if the, and if that was a little crooked. That's why you buy an aluminum yoke. Hopefully this will squeeze it together, put the bearings right in there. Proper place. I mean, it's pretty close. It's pretty close. I'm not gonna put Loctite on it yet. Let's see what happens here in case. It's easy. Back it out. The other side, just in case your bearing's just a little bit crooked, it should set it straight. It's pretty tight, so I don't think it's too much. Just gonna tighten it to put it together. Pretty tight to clean. Plastic. It's gotta break itself in. You gotta put a little grease in there. And as it starts to break in, it should get easier. So I think we're pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and put Loctite on it now. Make sure all your bearings are sitting properly. Looks good. Alright, let's get it done. So, when screwing into plastic, I'm done using Loctite on plastic to plastic. I put Loctite on my upgraded aluminum ball pins, and the screw ended up Loctiting itself right to the pin. Causes more tension. So I suggest just in your motor plate pretty much, and any aluminum upgrades you're screwing into, I would add Loctite. Otherwise, it's up to you, but I would stay away. Catch it in the beginning. This is a hot racing yoke. Part number ATF11Y02. Aluminum yoke for Arrma 1/10 4x4. It's also working with 3S. Granite, I believe. Granite. Something. I don't know about a second. It fits a bunch. Same platform as the kraton. You got a plastic chassis. I believe it works. Okay. This go around, I'm adding car grease all around here. So let me sit this sitting in here. Hot greasing up. Sitting like this. I'm gonna throw a little bit of grease in. I usually just put silicone around the whole base and then cap it off. But this go around, this being plastic and you know it's gotta break in, we're gonna add some grease. I watched a couple of YouTubes and people are, you know, literally just packing these. I'm a mechanic, so you know, I got this right outside. You're gonna work against me or help me, so I believe it's gonna help me. Just gonna keep it a little warmer. Still winter. I've seen the guys completely pack these with, I don't agree with that, but I mean, you can just add a little bit in here. Yeah, I believe that's going to help the situation. What I don't know is if it could be good for your bearings or bad for your bearings. I would say, you know, probably helps them out. Maybe two more. Like I also said, I got the steel diff coming in, but you know, I missed my Kraton, so I don't know, I had a stock one lying around. Because I broke it twice, got the Easy Max 8 running. Another thing not positive about is this punch. You know, it could run 6S, so when you adjust the punch on this one, are you adjusting the, is it stronger than the Kraton punch? Could be. So I had it set on stock level 3. Put the batteries back on now so I could slip, have this all together for a reason. I won't take everything apart, but put these on, pull your yoke up, slide these into your axles. Just goes back together faster. Little trick. So I'm gonna move this in. That's why it's a tool. A lot of people lock tight these right here too. It is metal going into metal, but I don't know. I say Loctite works against me for most of the car. Like I said, a few pieces. That's all that gets it. glad that fell off. I haven't had a pump of grease into the bottom here. Pretty much just where that to seal better. Okay, so the trick. Let's put this in. You can slide these going down one side and the other side. Your fist back in, and then I'll tip out all your extras. So, we're ready for the diff cover. Okay, that's nice and clean. If you glue it out, there's plastic in there somewhere. And I think I'm good with it. Yeah, I almost want to throw off. A little grease in here. I've seen people pack them, really pack them with the 6X. I think this is going to help the situation. It's because it's plastic, you know? You're definitely going to do it with metal. You don't want that metal grinding up against everything and chipping it away, but I think in the end this is going to benefit. I will let you know for sure. Alright, so. So we'll flip her over now. Hold that intact and just start the two here first. Gotta hold the top, that's an actual diff cover. You gotta hold the whole brace. Same, one is longer. You don't want to put this one in until you do the cover on. And make sure the axle is still. Had nothing, Buffalo. Watch out, Houston. Yeah, New England lost to the Texans, but not Buffalo. essential upgrades, get RPM arms, definitely worth it. These aluminum ball cups, definitely worth it. Are we gonna change the shocks out? Maybe. Centimeters off, but these eyelets break like it's your job. I already had probably four waiting to go in. One in the front here, front piece already broke off. The rest are intact, but I'm thinking they're gonna give these shocks a go. Multiple upgrades happening here. So let's take these out of the oven. Let's see how these at least fit. That's nice. For example, no breakage. I believe the screw is back. Well, I might have saved the shaft right there. Now you find. Spare parts bin. Damn. Four spare shocks. Spindle, rebuilds. They leak like this. They always leak. Rebuild them. Fill them up. They leak. Well, that's why I'm giving these a go. Hub. Cap. Screw. Eyelets, spacers, old bearings, beds. Come on, man. Got the screws. Mm-hmm. And you look like you have a replacement. Looks like crooked ones going back in. to do yet. Not doing chocks. I have to shorten this with the Dremel. Gotta shorten that a little bit. Shave a little off. Try the other one, see if I can ugly this one. It's a front. Get that one, that's a front. Shut. It's so much smoother. But this switch is pretty good. These are crazy spinners. Off of the other shocks I have here. But I'm really gonna be ready to go, so do a little test run. See how they work out. You could do that at the end. I was just curious if these were going to go on there or not. And they could have probably fell. There's the other side right there, too. So much smoother. I think I gotta run them. Ball cut there. That's two sometimes. We move around a little bit more, but it's a good thing to move. finish off the diff. So the cover's on. I cut my wing assembly off intact. A little faster doing it this way. So you get your shocks on, you get your two screws on for you. Tight there. You can put your back end on now. Slide the mounts.